Oh, why are there so many awful games on this platform? It's unbelievable, and it keeps getting worse even after the previous game. Well, on the other hand, at least we have another relic for our museum already, and that relic being the absolutely awful and unplayable Dream Saunas Vector Soccer. And I don't know this particular player, to be honest. Apparently it was pretty good or popular at the time, but when this game was made, he must have been really, really short on cash to lend his name to this crap, because yeah, the box of this game said it was the world's first football simulation to feature mathematically calculated vector graphics, giving the pitch action a stunning level of reality. And yeah, I would say the first part of that statement may be true, but the rest of it is just an absolute blatant lie. And the box goes on about smooth vector graphics and all sorts of great features like three-level artificially intelligent computer opponents, and I don't even know what it means. But the reality is, this is just a heap of unplayable crap that should never, never have been released, ever. And as you all know, I tried to keep my channel free from profanity, which is hard enough in this trash museum in the first place. And for this game it might even prove a little bit difficult, because I had a test run and I found myself swearing a lot. Because this game truly redefines trash in every single way. It's just unbelievable. On the other hand, I committed to this museum and I committed to the no profanity rule on my channel. So let's just have a go at the game and try to keep it decent, which is the least I can do. And yeah, as you can see, I'm playing a cracked version here, which for some reason doesn't disable the key click. And yeah, we come in the title screen, and some stuff in this game may look promising. The title screen does not. And remember, this game was released in 1991 for what would be 75 euros in today's money. This was a fully priced game, no budget title. And yeah, to be honest, the title screen looks more like something from 1986 or maybe 1987. It's not very impressive. And of course, after loading the title screen, we hopefully soon get into the option screen. At least the loading times are not as super long as the previous game in this museum. And of course we have a title screen with digital music, with some credits rolling over. And digital music might sound impressive, so William Hensel is probably really proud of it. But I would point out that actually a lot of games in 1986 already had a title screen with digital music in it, so this is not really a big big achievement. So let's just press the fire button and go to the option screen, because yeah, the first option I have is to begin a tournament, which yeah, with this awful, awful game, I would never do. I don't know how many games I have to play, but it's more than one. And one game is already too much to play, so I'm not going to do that. I will go for a single player game. But first I'm checking the game time. Then by default, lucky for us, it's set to 2 minutes, and that's already quite long. I mean, 5 minutes is already too long. So 2 minutes per half, which means that the total game time will be about 5 minutes or so, with some pauses. But imagine playing the game with halves of 45 minutes per half. I would really not advise that to anyone. You don't want to do that, trust me. And of course I do have options to change the game detail, like player detail, goal, nets, etc. And I can like remove the stadium stands and roof. In my experience, none of these actually improve the performance of the game, not noticeably anyway. It stays absolutely horrible. So I don't know why these options are in there. Even the ST line of computers, they were pretty fixed when it came to hardware. So if you want to add around adjust, I mean, make the game just detect what machine you have and adjust the game detail accordingly. Don't make this a problem of the user. And yeah, it doesn't make a difference anyway. So I don't know why that's in there. And I'm just going to start a single player game where I can, yeah, first have the option to change where my players will be. And I don't really know why, because yeah, this doesn't serve any purpose. The AI of my other players is so bad that I don't think it makes any difference where I place them. So I'm just going to press the fire button, or what is it, space bar in this case. Yeah, I have to press a key. And there's of course, yeah, some grid that I have to type, and this is the copy protection of the game. This is a cracked version, so I think I should be fine whatever key I press. But of course, yeah, we can hear the background sound, but there's actually no gameplay, so oh come on. But I can press escape and start another one. Let's see if I'm a bit more lucky, because now there's no copy protection option and the game has started, and I'm apparently the blue players. So I think I'm playing from what was it, left to right in this case. And just look at that. I mean, this is just absolutely horrific. How am I supposed to play the game in this way? And what? And I know it has digital sound effects, which serve no purpose at all. And I'm not entirely sure if I even... Why is he running away from the ball? Oh man, this is just... Yeah, that little blue dot there. Why are they running away? Come on. What is this computer AI? And the blue dot means I'm actually controlling that player, but as soon as another player comes near me, it's just... Oh, I'm actually going the wrong way. Why am I doing that? And... Yeah, the only positive thing I can say is a positive discovery I made, because we have officially finally found a game with a lower frame rate than Barbarian. And that says a lot, because Barbarian was about 3 or 4 frames per second, but this seems to be more like 2 or 3. And man, also that player animation, it doesn't make any sense. And what? Come on, that player wasn't even near me, and yeah, and as soon as I come near him, he's... Nope, what? Oh. And it's a throw-in for the computer player. And even, look at that frame rate. That's just absolutely horrible. Lucky for me, he just threw... Just crazy threw the ball right in. And I don't know how to do this goal kicks. I don't know how to kick it far or not far. And why are they running in the other direction? Come on, it's at least... And I don't think I even have the option to select a player that I'm going to control. I have to wait until... Oh, I have to wait until he's... Oh, come on! Let me at least give me the feeling of gameplay. And this was the first half, and I'm really happy I chose 2-minute gameplay, because imagine doing 2 times 45 minutes of what you just saw. And I'm desperately trying to get some gameplay in, but it's just so sluggish and so unplayable, and it's just... And they talked about 3-layered AI on the box, and apparently that means the computer player will just do nothing at all. I mean, how am I supposed to... What? Oh. How am I supposed to get some gameplay in? It's just absolutely horrific. I mean, I never thought I would say this. I never thought I would say this, but the gameplay in this game, in this soccer game, is even worse than Pro Soccer 2190, and that says a lot.
Corner.
Oh, it's a corner kick. What? Ah, it's second half. I was actually playing the wrong way. Of course, it's the second half, so I have to play in a different direction, and I wasn't doing that, which was a bit stupid. But I have no idea what's going on. I'm just sort of pressing the joystick and pressing the fire button, and hoping that... Oh, he's too slow. Oh, come on. Overtake that player. Take a sprint. At least... And he's taking... Yeah, and the crowd is cheering because that guy almost scored an own goal. And where are my other players? I mean, really, is there anyone going into some sort of position where they actually...
Throw in.
They are just really... What? Throw in. Let's see if I can get it in front of the goal. But of course, none of my players are even near that position. It's just, come on, I have a throw-in near the goal. At least take some position about around the 16-meter area. Yeah, I guess it makes it a kind of realistic soccer game. There's not much happening and nobody's scoring. But how can I play? How am I supposed to play this game? It is... As soon as I am sort of near any other player, and the frame rate is so low that it seems that the AI detects that he's near me and the guy already kicked the ball. And it... Oh. And it's also no... I can't make tackles, I can't make slidings, I can't do anything. I can't do anything. And this is it, this is the game, and it's... The good news is I got through it without cursing, and the only reason is because actually... I chose to do only 2-minute gameplays, and I'm already completely fed up with this game. I mean, imagine paying 75 euros in today's money for what you just saw. That complete lack of gameplay, complete lack of AI, shockingly low frame rate, which doesn't get any better if you change the detail. It's just absolutely horrific. I thought Pro Soccer 2190 was bad, but this is just 100% worse. I am not going to play another game. It's just, I hate this game. I really hate it. There is no gameplay whatsoever. You might think, well, they did pack a lot of features into it and try to do something new, which partly probably would be true, but again, if this is the best result you can get, why bother releasing it? Why not just admit you couldn't get it to work and leave it at that? I mean, there were people who paid good money for this, and they really literally got nothing in return. I mean, only heartless people would release a game and that you cannot play. And that's exactly what they did. I have so much anger in me right now, even after playing for only 4 minutes. I just wish I could go back in time to execute these people. So before I even get angry and do start cursing, I should really end it here. And I guess I have to say thank you for watching, and hope to see you next time in a more positive attitude. Oh God.